Could we get here with Smoke Toast, the second semi-finals? And it's Kick-Ass. I was partial on starting off with Auras. And you know T-Wave is a good move, so that boy decides to click T-Wave. Turn 1.
Alright, can you hear me? Can you hear me?
There was Echo, so I had to leave. So he's soft-bolt fishing for the para. Doesn't get it, and I think there's a Bandit Oz which just blows the Clef out the window. I didn't get it. My time yet to look at the matchup. Let me see. So I brought a pretty offensive team with Mega Gardevoir, and I mean, Kick-Ass's team is like, he has like these two bulky ones, so it's like a bit more balanced-ish. You can still call it bulky offense. As he did double into Weavile, predicting the Latios, I think. Oh my god, I did a fuck ton, so that's probably Mega Slowbro, because it runs, Mega Slowbro runs Spadef, and it doesn't have the physical bulk before it Mega Evolves. Yeah, Thunder is a big threat. Lati can like kind of switch in. But yeah, some Thunders carry knockoff, which would make Lati not a switch in, but like HP Ice usually it doesn't to a KO. I mean, does he lose anything on clicking T-Bolt? We did see that Clef was like T-Wave softball, so I assume that was a common Clefable. And so that might be a tank chump then with rocks. Or just offensive rocks chump. I don't think it would be wild enough to run rocks Bisharp. Yeah, like, I'd probably kick T-Bolt here. I mean, it's like, tough. He does go on the Lati, okay, and he's Volt Switch, so he might be that leftover set that, like, that, I think the Thunderous set, like, I think Nintendo used it was ABR, so Angela used it was Poeg, it's like, Volt Switch, HPIs, leftovers, but what are the other two moves? Man, I forgot the other two moves. Probably T-Wave and the last. Oh yeah, it was Incinerate. I don't know if T-Wave was the last move, but I know that Incinerate, Volt Switch and HPIs were on that set. But yeah, it's gonna click Hyper Voice here. Pick up a kill with his God of War on the Lati. Nice unnecessary crit. And yeah, Bandit Weavile, I assume, can click knockoff here and get a, I mean, either get a kill or get rid of an item, basically. Like, Azumarill can kind of switch in, but Azumarill is also paralyzed. So yeah, you know, he didn't get paralyzed so far, which is like, Para is so broken, or else I'm kind of surprised that he didn't get Para yet. Landris is also a good play. If it's Bandit Weavile, most Weavile are Bandit and Auras. Yeah, he can get up with rocks, he can also U-turn here. If he wants to maintain momentum. Like, U-turn on a Slowbro? Yeah, exactly. I mean, he didn't go Slowbro, but keeping the momentum is just worth it. And yeah, he is a tank jump. So that's like some variation of that one team that Steve... Actually, it's not a variation of the team that Steve Angelo used. I just mixed up the two teams because Steve Angelo used the tank jump with a Thundereth. With a Thundereth on the same team. But yeah, the teams are completely different. And this, yeah, Gardevoir speeds tank jump and gets blown away. So it looks pretty good for partial. He can protect to see what we will lock delve into, but he can also just. Oh god, he goes hard and sacks with Lando, okay. He's gonna get 2 KO'd here, obviously. I mean, he can save this, but it's not worth it. It's not, yeah, it's not. So, I assume there's gonna be a Scarf Excadrill, and He's gonna double here. Oh, he might have Toxic. If he has Toxic, he can click Toxic here. Predicting the Slowbro to come out. Damn, I didn't expect Porsche to go in like this. I mean, yes, Slowbro can maybe win, but I assume this has Toxic. Like, the way he brought this out. I mean, if that's just a potential play, this might have Toxic. If it doesn't have Toxic, he can double switch on the Slowbro. Did he double switch? Okay, just Earthquakes for damage, that's fine. But yeah, Slowbro is a bit dangerous here. It can Calm Mind. Yeah, Slowbro is dangerous. If he didn't have Toxic, I probably would have double switched. Looks like he was 100% going Slowbro there. Yeah, the game is not over. So he does go Hardness Thunderous because the Slowbro is a big threat. He's not Leftovers, he's just Volt Switch. Like, lately I've been seeing Leftovers on Volt Switch. So I assume... Oh, he does have T-Ball and he picks off the Weavile. I did not expect that to kill. Maybe it's like some boosting item. Is it... Did it change up moves? Is it Specs? Is it like... Or is it like just Electric Plate or something? Like, earlier I did use... Oh, nice, he switched on the Sucker Punch. Porsche is getting the plays correct now. What did the Weavile go for earlier? The Thunderous, I mean. This Azu never gets paralyzed and never gets flinched. This Azu is so well trained. Yeah, so if he gets paralyzed here, Slowbro just can still win, yeah. Oh, that did absolutely nothing. Never mind. That did zero, yeah. Yeah, I mean, I completely forgot. Mega Slowbro is a beast. Okay, so this game is not over yet. He can Calm Mind again here. Like, he did Volt Switch early on the Lardy. And did 28 to a Lardy. I just want to see if that's, that's a Specs Thunderous. Yeah, T-Ball should do 22 to 26 to Lardy if it's alive or Thunderous. If it's a Leftovers, never mind. But the Volt Switch at 28, so I think that might be Specs Thunderous. Like, just from how it just blew the Weavile away. I think that's Specs Thunderous. So yeah, Porsche has to think here. Like, just looking at his team, it's kind of weak to Slowbro, so I thought he might have... Yeah, he has Specs Thunderous, but Specs Thunderous doesn't want to switch in. I thought he really would have Toxic on Drill. Yeah, no, it's not that common on what I assume is a Scarf Drill, but... It just would make a lot of sense. Oh my god, this game is over. Kick-Ass just turned it around with his Slowbro. He can Calm Mind again here, so he... Like, he needs all the Calm Minds he can get. If he has Taunt on his Gardevoir, I would have gotten Gardevoir as ASAP. I mean, T-Bolt will still hurt. T-Bolt will still hurt, don't get me wrong. I assume he's gonna do 40. It's still 50. So he can still get a para here. He can't crit it because it's Shell Armor. Okay, that was a high roll to 50. Never mind, that did nothing. So is Robo really pulling it out here if he doesn't get a para? So if he had Taunt on Gardevoir, maybe he should have gone Gardevoir. To keep the Slowbro in check, but now the Slowbro will get all the comments. Man, I thought Porsche had this easy. Because I was... I mean, don't top Mega Slowbro. If you don't have Toxic, that monster is gonna destroy you. I once beat like a Belly Drum ZardX 1v1 with Mega Slowbro. I just went for Iron Defense. And I just ate that for Snackfest, like... I went for Iron Defense twice and plus 6 Dragon Claw bounced off then like nothing. Oh my god. Okay, that thing he kinda choked. Oh, Shake too was talking to him. Yeah, I think what he means is that he should have gone into Gardevoir. Maybe he doesn't have taunt on God of War. But yeah, if he has taunt on God of War, if he has taunt on God of War, he should have gone to it before the Slowpoke got up all the calm minds. But the protect makes me think that it might be a wish protect hyper voice God of War. The last slot is a will-o-wisp. Yeah, will-o-wisp is an option. So what I would have done if I was Porsche, like if I didn't have Toxic on that X-Get drill earlier, yeah, here's will-o-wisp. If he didn't have Toxic on a drill, which he probably doesn't have, I would have doubled into Sandris earlier, because that slow was so obvious. Like, yeah, it's kind of risky play, but like, she wasn't actually. I don't remember if that was the turn. That was which turn did the Slowbro come out again? Oh yeah, now he's going for Rock Slide flinches. Yeah, this is over. Gigasa takes auras, dang. And he's even missing the Rock Slide. Not that it matters. I just want to try to figure out which turn he actually went for the setup. How Porsche could have potentially prevented that. From happening. Yeah, Self is doing -5, like you can wrap this up. That's a GG, Lord. Oh man. I mean, I'm fine with either player winning. Little rooting a little bit more for Porsche probably. Like, no Porsche. I know Porsche more than Kick-Ass, so yeah. But I also have French people in my Discord, and they're obviously rooting for Kick-Ass. I mean, there's no point in narrating that this game is over. Narrating this turn. The only thing that I'm trying to figure out is when the Slowbro come out. So at one point he did go. Yeah, he did go for Earthquake, and then he scalded and burnt the Sunbreath. So the burn on the Sunbreath was kind of huge. Yeah, the burn on the Sunbreath was one huge thing, because then he could just Slack Off spam later on. Damn, so we're just soloed. Reduce Slowbro. When did the Slowbro come back out? I mean, he just should have probably. It's tough to say, because like. They already started the next game, which is Black and White. So I might just do that one in the. I might just do all in one video. Okay, let's just put Porsche on the same side. Because, yeah. We had Kick-Ass on the other side in game one. So I bought a Sun team with. Gossetel, that's disgusting, dude. Look at this trapping. Shadow Tag, Pursued, and Arena Trap. Get me out of here. Okay, Porsche brought some rain again. Let me see what we have this time. This is a little bit different than the rain that he brought last time. Like, I'm still not 100% sure what the last game, like. Like I said, like, I really thought he would have Toxic on Scarf Drill if he's so weak to Slowbro, besides the Sunrise. I know the Sunrise beats the Slowbro, but can't really switch it in. Okay, let's talk about this game now. I assume Ladi runs Serve, right? Because it's like rain boosted. Oh my god, Kick-Ass gets the lead correct. And if this is not Scarf Ladi, it's already looking bad for Porsche. And I don't even know if Scarf Draco would kill. Baby Bill was Yu-Yu in Gen 5, I didn't know that. Yeah, I think, yeah, that's true. Yeah, Scarf Draco is a roll, but it's like in. It's a 56% chance to kill. Okay, so he does go for Bandit Pursuit. I assume that's Bandit. So the light is not Scarf, so I could see Specs alive. Oh yeah, Specs, I assume. So nice. Poshu gets rid of one trapper and gets that play correct. And he sees Choice Scarf Gothitelle picking off the Latios with Psyshock. Yeah, Shadow Attack is a disgusting ability. I'm glad we got rid of this in Gen 6. Because you can just trap certain walls. It's kind of like Ductrio's Wall Corona. I mean, this team has all sort of trappers, so. But Ductrio's Wall Corona is like what is still allowed in Gen 7 at the moment. So that is why I mentioned that. Would this be offensive Zapdos? I've never really seen a Zapdos in Black and White. That's the problem here. I mean, the Gothitelle is nice to like cripple a lot of stuff, but like the Zapdos is really annoying. So I think he might go Gothitelle here. It goes Doggy. Wait, what? What do you predict there? I just predicted an electric move. I mean, this is a free Scald, Hydro Pump, whatever he has. I assume it's gonna be Scald because it's a bulky Toad, I assume, and if it has Hypnosis. Wait, why did he go for that? No, what is happening? Blanda said that was a great... Who said that was a great play? Oh, Blanda said that was a great play. Are you people stupid? Poshu's on some next level shit. I mean, I don't really know what the hypnosis thing again accomplished. But it did accomplish something. I mean, Volcarona is a threat. Because, like... I assume it's gonna be... Scarf Drill. With Scarf Drill, Volcarona goes in. But like, because it outspeeds that, Scarf Kelly would be the only thing that outspeeds the Rona. And they don't, this is not like Sun and Moon where Kelly runs Stone Edge, so he needs the rain. He needs the rain up for Kelly to be able to do like a lot of damage to Volcarona after Crivet ends. I should open Discord, man. I should have done this way earlier. But we had an echo earlier, so I didn't want to do it, and I also like narrating myself. I like narrating myself for Auras and Sun and Moon, but for Black and White I just can't do it. Like sometimes I can, but so it's Metal Sound Zapdos, that's really interesting. So that's like to beat Calm Mind Sweepers. And also it also works with Quivenant. I'm lagging a little bit here. Is he gonna go ducky now, predicting the electric move? I mean, I don't think the Zapdos would have Heat Wave in the rain. So I would assume that it's like Roost and two attacks. Let me see the young Discord. Stop tagging me, horses, I'll join. Like, Kikeza is not staying in here. I don't see him staying in. I mean, the Sun Boosted Fire Blast would do a lot to a Zapdos, but I don't think it would kill. Volcarona. Mm-hmm. Corona versus Zapdos. Okay, so it's thunder. That makes a lot of sense because he has rain. Hitting his thunder in the sun is actually like not that easy. Yeah, these guys are not joining the call. I'm not hopping to the call with like 500 people. We have one with like a lot of people. I'm not jumping to that one. Fire dance our fire blast. Okay. So it's like consistency, like it always hits and can get a boost. He's just going back 9 tails, I assume, to change the weather, yeah. Is he just gonna try to hit a thunder here? Why was Finch muted? What happened there in the chat? With HP eyes on the doggy lord. Yeah, that was tactical. Whew. Perfectly. Doesn't work on us to win. I'm pretty sure, I mean, there's no reason Volcano wouldn't carry Giga Drain, so yeah, it's a really big threat, that's for sure. Man, I got interrupted earlier, like, it's so annoying. So now he did get the Politoed on the switch, doubles out on the Gossetel, which is a cool play because if he gets rid of the rain, the Walker Arona becomes like even more threatening. I mean, I assume he's gonna trick this scarf to cripple it, or... Wait, this could already be scarf, we don't know the item yet. It's not leftovers, this could already be scarf, yeah. What am I saying? So he might just go for the 2K with Psyshock and Kalk. Yeah, let's say scarf versus... Yeah, Psyshock is 49 max, so... 41 minimum, so 2 hit KOs from here, so he can Psyshock and 2 hit KO this, yeah. Should be fine. Okay, that works too, I guess. I mean, he does reveal a vest, rest, oh, he's vest chest, though. Okay, so that means he's a bulkier Politoed. Let's say only defensive, so Psyshock would have done. Okay, Psyshock wouldn't have done enough, so I can understand Kickers are switching. But this is just a little bit too much for me, like. I don't know black and white well, and. I'm also really tired, but I stayed up for you guys. Gonna catch some sleep after this. And yeah, I hope at least the audio is better on this one. Yesterday was completely messed up with like a lot of people in call. Like, I don't have anything I would let Padlop call, but like, that boy sounds like he's in a washing machine, like, for real. Does he get a flame body? He doesn't get it. Dude, this Trapper team is just so disgusting. I would never want to play this, because he has, like, technically the tools to trap, like, everything, and then Volcarona just sweeps, like, everything that is in the way for Volcarona. Don't you just click water move here? Because the Anantils can come back in, but it's at 54. Oh god, he clicked Quiver Dance X. Okay, so I have to click Thunder here and get a para or something. Oh, crit. Or do they carry HP flying? That's an option. I think, nah, it was HP Ice, he already revealed it was super effective on the Dagger. Yeah, it was HP Ice. So Volcarona also has the super effective, I think that's HP Ice. I think I've seen HP Water once on Volcarona in the rain. The Thunder did nothing, so yeah, it's looking bad for Parshaw. Also, the drill is blue and it's not Scar, so makes me think that the Kelio Scarf. Yeah. Kelio should be Scarf, right? You need some speed control. I mean, you can also have. Did this Excadrill already reveal the ability? I don't think he has Mold Break. I think it might be Sand Rush. If the opponent has a Tita, you can also have that Sand Rush and abuse it with this drill. Wait, I'm kind of confused what happened here. Like, he was in a really good position with the Volcarona, but he switched it out. I just can't analyze this. Man. Why can't you guys have just played Sun and Moon? Yeah, this is where this is where I need my call to back me up, the black-white knowledge. Okay, they're saying Volcarona needs the sun up, okay. I don't understand 90% of Kickasses plays this game. I mean, I don't understand anything either, but that's just because I don't play black and white, and this is such a wild team, dude. Like, I mean, I would get Porsche's team if the opponent also had a regular team. I could, like, get it better then. I mean, this is fine. Actually, he tricks him a Scarf, it's annoying for Porsche, but it's not the end of the world. Because the Totus would be still around and could still change the weather back. If the Ninetales like sets up the sun. It means that this game is pretty good. Maybe the game is good if you know what how black and white works, I just don't get it much. Like, some black and white I just understand by now, because it's like, with Spexer Dragon, those teams I can analyze, that's not hard, but like, this is just some wild double, triple trap action. And this miss a Hydro Pump, which sucks. And they would have done like, something like 35% maybe. It's defensive, it would have done. Yeah, probably like 30. Is that in the sun? Yeah, that's in the sun. But Ninetales might be offensive. So he switched out the Ninetales into Volk, and what happened with here? Brought the The Axe predicting what? Not really sure, man. You just don't get that much this game. I mean, I got the turn one, where he, like, predicted the pursuit. That was pretty cool. So he does reveal the entire moveset so we can get some information here. He's just gonna go back into Toad, I assume. Yeah, you don't wanna get your Excadrill getting roasted. And he has to click Hydro Pump basically, so maybe Kikesa is trying to stall out the Hydro Pumps. So if the Hydro Pumps are gone, Volcarona basically sets up all over Politoed. I mean, he would not let Politoed in on Volcarona, obviously. Okay, that's nice damage. Does connect this Hydro this time. Does it have to coming out finally? Good lord, like, I don't even know what this team is, like. Ooh, it does live on 1%, that was clutch. I think it would have just been over. It would have been over for Porsche, like, he would have won if he killed there. Yeah, he's forced back into Toad here, I assume. Oh, it's a bulky of Volcarona. Bulky of Volcarona with Morning Sun, that's ingenious. Because he heals like 75 or whatever in the sun. Oh, rain. Gets up the rain, so Morning Sun heals less. Oh, that's really interesting. I love this game now. It's really tactical here. The weather change just making Morning Sun heal less. That's funny. Or like, this is a really cool mechanic. I don't know why I said funny. Oh, it doesn't have Giga Drain. I thought the entire time it had Giga Drain. I was like surprised. So it's the HP Ice. I think it was HP Ice that was super effective on the Zapdos. I don't think they're on HP Rock. Fire Rain's Curtains, Morning Sun. This is the worst sun team of all time. So he isn't Kelly with the rain up. Kelly should get... This Kelly got outsped. If it's a really bulky Volcarona, Kelly might still have outspeeded. But I assume Kikesa is gonna run enough speed to outspeed the common Scarf as after two Quiver Dances. I mean, he can't touch the Kelly, so the Kelly can spam its water move here. Morning Sun only has a few PP left. Yeah, that does absolutely nothing in the rain, and he does miss his Hydro Pump, which sucks. Oh god. Please hit. Oh my god, get me out of here. No. Don't do this. This is not funny, holy shit. 6 more to go. Don't do this to him. Just hit the next one. I'm just gonna have a heart attack if this misses again. I should have paid attention to the smog just shed a bit earlier, because like, black and white is really not my tier, and at least you get something funny out of the chat sometimes. Oh, we don't know Volk's item. So, yeah. There's no Z move, it's Gen 5. What is it? And he finally hits and he gets the crit, so the justice is here. And Porsche does take black and white. And we will be right back with the Sun and Moon. I might just put Sun and Moon in a different video because this was a bit wild for me and I'm like tired and stuff. And I mean, it depends. If they will start immediately, I'll obviously keep it in this. But he scores 1-1 now, and yeah, Sun and Moon is gonna be interesting because they're both really good at Sun and Moon. Yeah, the reason I might cut it here is because I'm recording in super HD quality and it's gonna take forever to upload otherwise. So I'll change my settings and turn it down to 720p. And yeah, I'll see you guys with game 3, so peace out.